Alright, I'm back, and I have done the necessary research. So, you know how there is this secret wall over here that led to this tunnel, that did open this orb, this door. So, and I did notice this secret passage over here that seemed, useful, that goes over by this wall. So did you guess that you're actually supposed to go over here and break that wall? Cause if you did, you don't win a prize, but, you know, you get to feel good about it, I guess. Alright. I don't know. I mean, I'm not a big fan of the cold either, but usually it keeps insects away. So, maybe there'll be fewer roaches on this level. Well, no roaches yet. Clearly want to hit that orb, right? We also need to get west of this well, wait a second, me. Okay, so we want to... Hold up, so we want to... Well, we definitely have to kill that, Tar Mother before that happens. That's not negotiable. This is actually more negotiable, though, because I could lure a Tar Baby up through here, and, that would be fine. Maybe let's just try and hit the orb first and worry about this second, I guess. Yeah, that's what I thought. Keep that brain over there. That will let me kill these more efficiently. Alright, but now I gotta rush up here. But yeah, it's okay if the first Tar Baby goes up, well, just there, in fact. It's good if I leave the brain alive, because I can cut through this faster. That's probably the whole point of that. And I'm one move short, but I can probably get that back. Just by reordering this. That's more or less how I expected this room to go. Essentially. That's probably not a good way of doing it, though. Oh. Well, also, we need to avoid that, too, so... I guess I can... I'm not really using the decoy for anything, so I can try and make that play to my advantage somehow. Not really seeing that one, though. Yeah, we need to optimize our approach to this a little bit better. I guess that works. We'll even kill that Wraithwing on the way too. Sure, why not? Well, that's why not. Yeah, we're kind of losing turns doing this, is the thing. I'm not really dealing with this set of two Tar Babies as efficiently as I could be. That's a little bit better. I think that might have saved me the moves I need. No, still not. Still missing one. There's no time to run back here. That would have been an interesting way to save time, is just... Don't kill these three Tar Babies, instead go back and teleport a decoy right onto the Tar Mother. The thing is, though, even if I... Well, yeah, if I do that, then this second Tar Baby doesn't get spawned, so we are all good, if I can do that. We're just, like, tantalizingly close. So there's two sections to deal with. The Tar Babies to take them, like, the most efficient path to me that they can. And not get hung up killing them, because I have just barely enough time to do this. Okay, what are my other options? Are there any other tools in this room that I can use? I could use the Wraithwing, perhaps. That seems a little iffy, but maybe I can make that work. Oh, I forgot to hit the orb. Alright, so that gets down there where I'm hitting that orb. Not much to be done about that until that. I mean, I still need to turn my sword at some point. I mean, okay, that's possibly saved me one move, but it was a little bit awkward, so yeah, that didn't really help. But that's the sort of thing I guess I need to be thinking about, is just literally using the decoy to save one move. Which I don't think I've ever seen before in a room like this. Usually, the decoy has to go in a pretty specific place. I guess if I had, like, yeah, if I had, like, somehow, like, perfect timing, if I just got it absolutely, amazingly good, I think I could put the Wraith Ring on this square and prevent that one tar baby from spawning, which has been a little bit awkward to kill, and I think that would definitely save me some time. Could we make that happen? Maybe. Yes, just barely. Can I go up here? I'm kind of placed badly for this next part, but... Hard to say whether that helped or not. It was cool, though. It was cool. Let's see if I can have my sword be facing a better way after this first part. I think it's important that I turn my sword here. No, it is important that I not turn my sword here. It's important that I wait a move. Because that lets me kill all of these and come out with my sword that way. I could waste a move doing that to not have to deal with that one evil eye. If I could... no, that just wastes time. Not worth it. Way to move there. Okay, but now I have my sword facing west, which is better. Get to the tar faster that way. But I'm still one move short because I kind of wasted time turning my sword. So can I use the decoy then? Alright, so I get to the tar in the same amount of time. I make this cut at the same turn, but I save one turn not killing that target. This might do it. Aha! Alright. Then we lure that up, that comes to us, we kill the Wraith Ring, kill the brain. Kill the target. Alright, that was neat. I'm glad that Reb showed some constraint and only did this in the space of two spawn cycles, but that was neat. I'm glad I was able to actually use the decoy to good advantage there, because it's not necessary to use in order to actually deal with this tar baby at all. You're safe as soon as it gets on this force arrow. You don't need it to help you there at all. I'm thinking, now I'm thinking, could I have put it over here somehow? But I think, that first tar baby's already there by the time you make it to that decoy potion anyway, so... Might be kind of irrelevant, but anyway, I solved the room the way I solved it. There's probably other ways, but this is the way I came up with. I don't know why I'm going west first instead of east. It just occurred to me, but I guess it's alright. Okay, so my orb friend is now over here. Well out of the way, of course. Well, hold on. What's the fuse even look like, actually? I need to... Oh, well, this is just, little rude. Little rude, I say. Well, that's probably not the right way to go. Yeah, that's just not gonna lead anywhere good. I think I need to go to the south. Because I certainly have to deal with that. I don't know what my time limit is for hitting this sword, but I certainly have to deal with that. That is not a thing that I can leave alone. Can I kill this any faster? I guess I can. Yeah, I can stab that. That leads to nothing good, apparently. I can delay that by a turn. But that just leads to the wall taking place here, and it won't go west until now, because that's the first opportunity it has to do that, so... Yeah, this is, just not what I had in mind. Can I make that go north? Yes, I can. Okay, that looks a little better. Now we're starting to get somewhere, I think. Ideally, I would like to be able to just kill that on the way there. I still can't actually... Huh. Yeah, so that's already out of time. So I need to, like, make it past this servant somehow. So I don't have time to wait for that, the tail to make its way over here. But when did that happen? Way at the start. And then, of course, this is just gonna keep happening, because this tail and this head are just in sync, so I need to, like, already be caught up with it. So I guess I just need to destroy that tail as fast as possible, but I thought that killed me if I did that. Yeah, because then there is no way out here. Yeah, now you're just dead, so... You don't quite kill it as fast as possible, but you still do it in time to do that anyway. Because you still get three cuts on the tail, right? It was three? Yeah, one... Two, three. So you do make three cuts. They're just not all immediate, but you do make them pretty quick. Then I have to wake up one of these sets of eyes anyway, so I'll do that as late as possible, I guess. Or, wait. No, wait, this set of eyes is just pointing at the wall. It's useless. Okay. Alright, so that happens. I still, I've killed that pretty quickly. Just before it does that. Now that snake is in a bad spot, though. Of course, I've lured it, alright. Can you go up there? Yes, okay. That should work out a little bit better now, I think. Okay, good. Now that's not in the way. Now I need to kill these and make it to the orbit time. Okay, now we just need to kill the snakes. We've got a dead end over here. That'll be good enough. Okay, we're done. Rest is clean up. Rest is just making snakes behave themselves. Alright, rattlesnake, behave yourself. Go north. There we go. Alright, you go in here. Like, it's at this point where routine cleanup, even during routine cleanup, it's good to know your snake preferences, just because it makes the cleanup process go so much smoother when you just, have an idea of when how to send snakes into places that you need them to go into. Alright, so, yeah, this is pretty good. It's, not really that much harder than anything we found on the very first floor, but it's alright. It's a good, good-ish, optimization room. Not really anything special to it. I mean, the most interesting part was just cutting through that wall of snake over there, getting those three cuts in. But after that, the rest was pretty standard. Okay. Keeps going. This looks like another case where you don't want to kill the brain quite yet. We are on a time limit to... do what? Kill that particular eye. Alright. Okay, well, we'll save one turn doing that. Okay, get that done just in time. We are on a time limit to stop that from happening. We could kill the brain. Because we do still need to, let's see, we need to kill this eye before that happens. That's gonna blow up before this spawns, but we also need... We would like to put an eye in here to stop this from becoming uncuttable. I mean, that seems like the most direct way of doing that, but I've already wasted too much time there. And I do have enough time to cause that to happen, so... So yeah, I think I really do just want to force my way through. Something like that, maybe? Yeah, there's just so much flesh in my way, though. Okay, well, can I use another... Yeah, killing that with a decoy doesn't help much. I can do that, I guess. Because I'd like to just go straight north. That's what I want to do. Guess that's sort of good. I need to, like, now I just need to go around this stuff. Somehow. Oh, if I go, if I put it down there, it wakes up more eyes, so, yeah. It's okay if I don't kill the eye on time, because I still need to, I just need to get on the door, but it's still not... Don't quite have a direct enough path yet. What if I put it over here? Kind of block this off a bit. Because now I can kind of go around and do that. Okay, so that's sort of good. Yeah, then there already has to be something in here. Alright, so obviously I, you know, I placed one decoy over here to save one move. These two were both here in order to do that, but the thing is, being all the way up here makes me really close to the eyes, so it's hard to figure out how I would use a decoy to my benefit to draw an eye down here, especially when, like, the only ways I've seen for that to help would be to put, like, a decoy down here or up here. Up here actually seems pretty promising if I can somehow make that... get one trap down here somehow. What does this look like? Okay, so it initially looks like that. Yeah, I'm not sure I'm seeing this one. Well... What I can do... is put, like... face that way first. I'm not really liking the way this is turning out. Because you really have to book it. You have to go, like, nearly straight through. At nearly full speed to do that. And there's no way to cut this fuse this time. You just have to get on that door, okay, as soon as possible. And it seems like you do need to use that to kill this time, because I did need that one spare move, right? Yeah, that's... I did have to save time somehow. I think that decoy is the only way to do it. I'm not sure if it's relevant which way it's actually facing. But yeah, you do have to do it. There's no sneaky way around that. This is just a... This is a way to set the tone. Then you got three of these. You can face west or northwest. I guess we'll try northwest. That does seem to have been a slightly more helpful sword direction. It does point me towards this at the very end. But it's not... Story direction isn't particularly relevant for this. It's, getting onto the door fast enough. Sword direction is handy for the decoys and for how that affects killing the eyes immediately. They're in your way. And somehow getting one down here. I'm still not sure how I'm actually going to do that yet. I guess killing this brain, but that's starting to seem less and less important now. Yeah, so I think I've pretty well decided there's no time to get Beether down here and then back up. I don't think that's happening. I think what's being asked of me is, yeah, so see, that's too wide. That's not, that isn't gonna help. So I need to somehow trap an eye somewhere on this diagonal, somehow, and then lure it into here by having Beether go over here or a decoy or something. I guess. I can't get around that tar baby. That's not gonna be relevant, I think. Or is it? No, I have to kill them like that. But yeah, there's no way to dodge around that tar baby. There's just no time. I'm thinking, like, what if I, like, dodge around it, go through here, the tar baby will lose track of me and start going that way. And I get caught on that, but that's not the issue. I have plenty of monsters, I'm just not fast enough. Like, if I had slightly more time, I'd have no problem just putting a loose one in here. It's just, you gotta go fast. So, maximum speed is necessary. Not sure what I'm being asked to do is the thing, because there's just like barely any opportunity to actually get far away from one of these things. I mean, all right, so I mean that's a thing. Like I can do that, but I can't do both. Okay, well, let's at least leave that alone. I've pretty well shown that I can do the first part nearly on command now, so it's just a question of figuring the second part out. It is tricky. I'm glad that it's short. I'm glad that this is short, but let's see what the East has in store for me now. I mean, we had the hints of a plot. We were trying to be assassinated by an army of assassins, which I'm not really sure is how assassins work. I think they were supposed to be, like, lone wolves, but, you know, whatever. And, then we were trying to keep the Underground Empire safe, but now we're just in a tunnel. Okay. Well then, I suppose we've found the warp route. Well, let's see where this goes. Ah. So, alright. Oh, but we're actually not at the entrance. You know what? I think I'm gonna leave this well enough alone. This looks, you know, that's, suddenly I'm not so interested in skipping ahead anymore. But, we know this is there for, future reference. First of all, I wasn't expecting to see a warp room directly east of the third level, or fourth, I guess. Wasn't expecting it to be out in the open, and I certainly wasn't expecting there to be a secret room inside the not-secret warp. This hole just gets stranger and stranger every episode. It's bizarre. At least on the plus side, you know, now these timers are pretty easy to disable. So, that's nice. But, Beether, you're really gonna have to invest in some, non-fuse-lighting shoes someday. Someday, when you get enough money. Now, Well, I'll give this a few more tries, see where that lands me, and, you know, we might be in good shape. We'll see. We'll make some good shape for ourselves. Well, I mean, I could do that, but that's gonna make me waste a move anyway, so we're not gonna do that. So that's actually the only solution I've found to this opening part so far, which is giving me a little bit of hesitation. Just the fact that there seems like only one obvious way to complete it, but maybe there's another one that somehow helps me with this. But this is all, like, so far away from this part, and this part is so tight that I'm just having such a hard time seeing how that could be relevant. Whatever I'm missing over here is very specific. Because, like, I've shown that it's reasonable to get up here. It's tricky. You do have to use these decoys wisely, but... You know, I'm still utterly nonplussed as to how you're gonna make bloodthirsty eyes go southwest when they would really prefer to be going southeast or east. That's, you know, that's one thing they certainly do, is they want to get right close to Beethro. And there's no real convenient places to put decoys, is the thing. Because, like, once you step past this force arrow, you're already so close to everything. You have to get 5 squares away from an eye. I mean, you can be 4 away. Like, you can be at the edge of... No, you have to be 6 away, in fact. You can be at the edge of this, like, this kind of range. Like, imagine this square overlaid on, say, this eye over here. If you're on the edge of that and you step out of it, then the eye starts getting attracted to the decoy. But, see, like, it still has to move south and west. So, like, this is... the best place you can put a decoy. You can put it over here, but then you have to get the eye down here and make it go up that way. This won't be good enough because it'll slide north. But I have no idea how you'd get an eye down here and make it stay down there. And still make it up here in time. Killing the brain might help, but at the same time it requires a decoy, so... I have a feeling you just need all 3 on this west side in order to make it happen. You just have to deal with the brain eyes in the meantime. This is really nasty. Like, I mean, this is Reb's first hold, so it's a little unfair of me to compare this to some of his later holds. But often in his later holds, like, I'm thinking Troshan Tower and Troshan Ground specifically, you had super precise optimization like this, but it was more obvious what good moves involved. Like, it involved, like, killing 2 monsters at once, or making an eastward move, or, placing a decoy in, like, a really specific place that was really obviously helpful. Here, it's just chaotic. Like, it's hard to say what's gonna be advantageous ahead of time or not. And I think I've said that before, but it's just really showing again in this room. A lot more than in the other two. In the other two, you had specific goals, and it was obvious whether you were on track to get to those goals or not. But here, who knows? I'm, not as much of a fan. Like, it is cool. Like, I haven't seen a room that's like this in quite a while. But it's still, still a bit iffy on the old trial and error. Let's see. Like, I wouldn't mind if this... Like, even if this fuse length were, like, 2 longer, like, 2 units longer, I'm still a bit iffy on how you actually get an eye in here in the first place. That's what's really throwing me off. There's got to be something else I'm just missing about it, but it's just, I mean, I think I have all the facts of the situation laid out in front of me. I just don't like them. That's just all it is. So let's see if I do it that way. You know, just put it down here. Like, can I even make it to the eye in time doing stuff like this? Because that's, like, seems to be what this is all predicated upon, is, like, having enough leeway to put a decoy in an out-of-the-way place that doesn't immediately help you get over here. And you still have to get here on time. And then you only have a few moves, like, let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Alright, so this blows up, and then you have just 10 more, like, You'll kill this with whatever timing you kill it with. Ideally sooner rather than later so you can start moving again, but whatever. You have to kill this at some point. And then you only have 10 moves left before this grows. So, and Beethor's, like, up here at this point. So there's definitely no time to go down here. That's just not happening. So, It seems like the only way that's happening is if you get, like, an eye down here or over here or something, and you can distract it up here somehow. Like, that's the only way I see that happening, and even so... Huh. Yeah, like, it might just be, like, a physical blockade. Like, it might be... Like, we might be looking at, like, getting an eye over here somehow. I don't know how. Somehow. But you literally do not have time. You do not have time to just be killing all these eyes. Because last time I made it up here, I think there were like three alive, or four even, chasing after me as I got on the door. Which is good. That's how you save time. Your goal is to get on the door, not kill all the eyes. But if you get bogged down killing all these eyes, you're not making it here in time. End of story. I guess I can try waiting here or move. That sends them south because they're pathfinding around the decoys. That doesn't help much though, because it still only puts them like down there, but it is something to note, I guess. Like, if I do that... Like, I can do this? I don't know why I would want to, but I can. Yeah, because it involves waiting, which you pretty much don't want to do in a situation like this, but I thought it was worth a shot. But, yeah, I don't see that... I definitely don't see that solving my problem over here, let alone up here. But I guess it's worth thinking about. Huh. See, that doesn't even work, like, doing something like this. I mean, this is sending me through south anyway, so it's still not doing anything good. There's definitely not enough time to go all the way around here and then to the back. I certainly can't go for the eye first. Like, you know, can't just ignore this part, I think. Yeah, there's definitely not enough time for that. What, are you crazy? No, that's not how this room is set up. Yeah, quit joking around. Yeah, but then I don't know what else to do. Alright, well... We're just gonna have to come up with something even more off the wall than I've already tried. That's just what I have to do, I mean... So let's review. How much time have I got from here to here? I'm facing west, I guess I could be facing northwest, so... Let's make it do that, just for the sake of argument. How many turns do I have from here to, let's say, here? The direct, straight line distance, going as straight as you possibly can... Like, just ignoring the eyes that are on the way entirely, is 2, 4, 6, 8 moves. How many moves do I actually have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. You have 6 moves of leeway to get up here. That is crazy. You can afford to make 6 moves that aren't directly tied to getting on this door, which I can sort of appreciate. I guess if like I had to worry about like 8 or 10 moves that weren't direct, then you'd have a lot more space for weird wiggling around that somehow caused this to work. There'd just be a larger search space, but I can at least vaguely sort of respect the fact that there's that little leeway. I'd almost respect it more if it was built around only having one or two moves leeway. Because, like, at least that'd be, like, way more direct. It'd be a lot more obvious that you have just no time at all. But six moves is that weird intermediate ground where you still don't have a lot of time, but you have just enough time for some funny business to be going on over here. Which is definitely what's being involved in somehow convincing an eye to go in here. Yeah, I don't know. Let's see if I can just pull myself together a little bit and try a few more times here. So Northwest has not actually really been my friend as far as killing eyes quickly. Just because it's kind of had decoys facing bad ways. I mean, I can think about it a little more, I guess. But yeah, you still kind of get hung up anyway. And it seems almost like you just have to, kill some of these ahead of time anyway. I'm not sure. Like these North Eyes are the real problem, so I think it's good to kill one of them. But then you're just not at a good angle to kill the rest of them. At least not facing this way. Alright, so what if I face west? How does that change matters? So it means I can place this decoy, like, here, perhaps. But then things are still kind of in the way. So if I, like, place one here, that's certainly not really being here. And then the fact that this decoy's here means that I can't go. It seems like I just don't want to put one here in the first place anyhow. I think this sequence of moves is what actually led to success the other time. But they're still just in the way. So just for the sake of argument, let's see if I can get this solved somehow by not turning the sword. Oh yeah, that was the problem. The problem was that when I turned my sword that way, the, alright, so that, definitely don't have time really to do anything else. Yeah, this thing, as far as I can see, this is just an artifact movement. I don't like, but that's just how shakes out, I guess. So just for the sake of argument, like the reason that this worked earlier was because I put the decoy up here to block these eyes physically from trying to go north up this wall, like brain monsters are wont. If I'm facing northwest, I can't kill this brain. You have to be facing west or some other direction. Northwest is not on the set of directions that can kill this brain, so that's not in the cards. If I put it up there, then this part works because that eye's not in my way, so I can get on the door, but I'm definitely not on track to get this part done. Like, I barely have had time to even get west of the force errors, let alone. Well, maybe if I go as fast as possible, like, if I just book it, I might be able to make it. Like, that seems really iffy, but maybe. Somehow. Like, I could sort of see that working if I actually had a good sword direction here. If I didn't have an eye right on me. But you really gotta go. But I could see that working. Yeah. With three more moves, I could literally just get B-Throw in there, and that would be fine. And I could sort of... I was definitely being inefficient as far as how I handled this. And I do have some freedom of movement in this section. It's not obvious, but I do. Like, for example, I could do this. So in fact, I could even lure them up this way. In fact, I want them all to go that way. But that's as far as I can go that way. And I don't actually like that as much. So close, though. If I didn't have to waste time killing these guys that are all clumped up around the door, then I'd actually be in good shape. So why don't I do this, then? Because that's even worse. That's why. Like, if I could lure them up into... Okay, well, maybe if I put the decoy in that place, then. Because I pretty much have carte blanche to put it anywhere I want. Not quite anywhere I want, but close. I can just make that go a little bit sooner somehow. How about I kill an eye with it? Does that help? And not really. It means that I only have that one over there, but that could maybe work. Okay. How about I kill this one? That's it. How about I kill that eye? Well, I'd certainly like it if that one were dead. There's no way to do that with sword facing northwest just because of the extremely specific steps that I took. But it is there. Well. What happens if I put it right in there? Then it is blocked. Okay. And then we still end up with that pattern anyway. Okay, what if I don't kill that eye? Then things get even worse. Because I need to do this, like, nearly perfectly. Like, I want to lure all the eyes over in that direction, almost. So I'm just losing time compared to the other way. Okay. Well, I guess if I'm turning my sword like that anyway, I guess I might as well be killing eyes while I do it, I guess. I mean, sure. Yeah, but I still want them to actually be one square away from me so that I can do this trick in the first place. I think that is as fast as I've ever done this section. I'm still 2 moves short. Cause like, well, let's review what happened there. In fact, I'm gonna even save a demo for reference. Alright, let's back up and see what happened. So, let's see. I did have to waste some time going around this decoy. That's my own fault. I put that there. It was really handy because I had to kill an eye that was just going to clog things up anyway. But I do have to go around the decoy. I am wasting time doing that. If I kill that decoy instead, then I can maybe go up a little bit faster. Problem is that eye is still over there. I'm trying to go north and kind of flank around. That's what brained eyes do. So doing that is saving me time, at least immediately. Not like in the long run. I can go around. Well, that's not fast enough. You want to take a direct path, of course, naturally. Like to be on the southeast corner and like go that way, I think that is why the checkpoint is there. That is a good place for the checkpoint. All right, there, finally. And yeah, okay, good. Because I figured, like, you can go out this force era, so you don't have to kill all the eyes on your way in. You just have to be able to survive. And in fact, the trapdoor even helps with that. Like, if I had any eyes right behind me, I would have been fine. Alright, jeez. Good riddance. I mean, that is... I mean, I will admit, I found a way to go faster. Like, I just figured, hey, I'm wasting time. What if I figured out a way to make my path shorter? And indeed, it did make my path shorter. It took a lot of finagling to make that path actually make Beethro survive. But I did make a shorter path. And, you know, look what it got us. Got us victory. Okay. Well, hold on a second. Now we can cut fuses whenever we want, but we still want to blow this up. I guess ideally, like, a little bit later, we'd want to blow that up on turn 30, I guess, maybe? I don't know. Then what does that do? Oh, that's interesting. Okay. So we're gonna light that fuse real quick. And then we're gonna have all these trapdoors in the way, which are gonna make for weird brain pathing, and I don't want to kill that brain because, gotta get through here ASAP, of course. Alright, well, you know what, I'm gonna save this room for next time. I'm feeling a little bit, tired, and I think it's a good idea to, you know, refresh myself a little bit, so I'll come right back when I feel, a little bit happy, a little bit, a little bit more optimistic about the future. I mean, it's good. I'm making progress. I killed four whole rooms. Well, I didn't kill this room, but I killed, like, a lot in this floor, and I killed, like, 11 million slayers, so, you know, I think Beethor could take a nap.